Hello everyone, in this session we will be covering another very useful feature available in Dynamics 365 Finance and Operation. This feature is for the end users who will be entering the data, whether it is concerned with supply chain module, or maybe it is for finance module, or any of the module available in Dynamics 365. Where you in various data entry forms or in journal lines, wherever there is a grid option available, so you can always copy and paste the values from Microsoft Excel. So this feature is normally not known to the end users, and that's why they are basically putting more time. Having more time into entering the data, although there are other options also available, like copy function is sometimes available in for example, if you go to purchase lines, there is a copy function, but we'll be targeting that one within another session. In this one we are targeting the copy and paste functionality from Microsoft Excel. So for that I will be basically demonstrating using a JV, a journal voucher. For that I need to go to journal, but that is not a specific case. So wherever there is a grid or there are lines, you can always use this feature. So basically I will go to journal ledger module and then journals, and here I will pick any of the posted journal. Okay, so I will try to find a simple journal, for example this one. This is already posted journal. You can go to the lines and you can see here there are three lines entered, so it is not using a single line based entry, but double entry based JV has been entered already. So what I will do is I will basically select the lines and export to the Excel and download the Excel file. As soon as the file is downloaded, I will open the file here. This is just for sample information or sample data available in Microsoft Excel, but it is not necessary that you also use the same technique. Rather, you can always just keep the same sequence of the columns and then enter the information, but it should be correct one. So that's it. I am just referring this to make it simpler, so that the sequence of the columns should be also same, and then you can change the information as far as it is correct. It will be easily pasted. So now this is the Excel file which I have exported from a posted journal. So if you want to also use the posted journal lines, so that option is also available. I will close this journal. Okay, so again I will filter it not posted, and I will create a new journal. Okay, so in this journal I will, if you want to give description, it is up to you, but for demonstration I am just targeting the lines. Go to the lines and you can see here a new entry is already there where you can enter the information within this entry. And you will be also thinking about this voucher number, because the posted voucher is having some other value, it should ideally not be used, but it will try to basically generate a new voucher number. So what I will do is I will pick up the three lines, for example, and I will select the values here. Okay, and then I will right click and copy the values, and I will go to the lines here and I will paste it here. So just select the paste value and it will save you, it will ask you, do you want to save your changes to this table? Yes, I want to save the changes. Change the journal amount? No. Okay, and you can see here all the values have been posted, and but except the voucher number, you can see here. So it will keep asking for each of the line, Okay, and but you can see the values are there, most of the values are there. Okay, but and voucher number is again a new voucher number has been generated, but you can see the account number has been missed here. So either you can manually type it here or you can just paste the same row here. Okay, just copy and again go here and paste the value here and save. So you can see now the account number is also there, and similarly you need to do also for the third line. If you want to avoid the, you know, the manual typing, you can again go to the this line and just paste the value, save it. Okay, now you can see the account number is also pasted correctly and voucher number is the new one. So this is so simple, you can do it. Although there was a, you know, the value was missed for account number, but for other, you know, journal types, you won't find it like it would be easy and to copy and paste the values from Excel. So I will just validate this journal so that the debit, total debit amount is equal to total credit, and any other error should not be there. So it is saying that it is journal is okay. So this is how you can perform this copy paste option, and this brings you ease for data entry for the end users who are working on whether it is on a finance module or maybe in inventory module or supply chain module, wherever there are, you know, for example, in the moment journal, if you want to enter the, you know, the line information within the moment journal, also you can use here as well. You can paste the values, if it is sequence is correct, it will paste in this grid. So same is true for the purchase order lines and or sales order lines. Wherever there is a grid option, you can always, you know, keep or maintain the values within Excel, and one time you can just copy it from here and paste it in within the lines. So this is so easy. The people who are basically, they have ease of working in Excel, so they can easily copy and paste the values within the journal lines. I hope this is informative, and this would, you know, be a new topic for the people or end users who have not so far, you know, used this option. So just go ahead and use the option so that it brings ease in your life. Thank you very much, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.